18 wheels rolling heavy through the desert night. I've been driving all day, but I won't shut it down tonight. Good morning, everybody. I am actually, hey, go sit down now. We are actually in a Blue Beacon getting our trailer washed out. We got to go to Dodge City and pick up our next load. Yeah. They're waiting for them to tell me it's good to go. Than trying to cross, and I was too close to that light to really get straightened out. So this is what we had to do, ladies and gents. Washington State, Auburn, Washington. what it is, Auburn.
In a half mile, turn left
9:30 tomorrow morning. We had it since, 1 o'clock in the morning on the 2nd, or something like that, to 8:30 tomorrow for that trailer to be loaded. So, I don't know if it is going to be loaded or not, but if not,
speed limit reduced to
there's a Lowe's right across the road. We could go over there and probably relax again until tomorrow morning. I'm not going to keep calling them or anything like that. If it's not ready, then 8:30 tomorrow, we'll just go. Yeah, right there. Might be. I think so. Plant entrance.
You have arrived at your destination, 11425, Fort Dodge Road.
We got our loaded trailer. Hope you guys don't mind. I just jumped out and hooked up real quick. I didn't want to mess around. And I don't want you guys to think I'm sick with this virus thing. I'm not. It's the allergies that are kicking my butt, and that's what's doing it. Other than that, I don't feel bad. Damn pollen out here. But it's spring, right? But it is what it is. Well, we got to get on the scale here. Well, as soon as that tanker gets off the scale. And we got to, well, orders from this place, you have to weigh your load. And they got to, if you don't, they won't let you go. Just waiting for the tanker to get off. He gets off. All right, now we're getting on. Make sure you don't drive off the scale. That would hurt, wouldn't it? Yeah, it would. Tear up the truck a little bit. Move that freight around if you do that. Guys, that guy, and I'm not making this up, guys, I'm being truthful. This guy wiped his nose, then wiped it on his pants, then he asked me for my driver's license, right? Because I gotta sign my bills. And I was gonna hold my driver's license. I didn't want him holding them. And he says, or no, I said, "Oh man, you had to grab my license, didn't you?" He says, "Well, if we get the virus, we get the virus. We don't give a shit." That's exactly what he said. "If we get it, we get it. We don't give a shit." Well, he made a viable point. I mean, if we get it, we get it. You know, there ain't nothing we can do or say or whatever, but I guarantee he goes home at night. So if he's got to put his carcass in the hospital, he don't have to worry about his dog. It's at home, right? I don't want to get the virus. Honest, I don't. Because I don't know what I'm going to do with Jake and Panda if that actually does happen. He said, "I don't give a shit."
US 283.
And that's an actual food progress, or, well, it's, Cargill, it's Cargill. Just don't give a shit. Oh, well, anyway, we got our load. And we are on our way to Washington State. Auburn, which isn't all that far away from Seattle. Actually, it's closer to probably Olympia, Washington. So we got until Tuesday, 8 a.m. Tuesday morning to get it there, and it's Friday. So let's get her down the road a little bit.